Welcome to Moby Dick. I'm Asia. Today, I got a new topic. Aren't you excited? Now, as you know, there is a device in the car that informs the driver about important information. It is called the digital cluster. When the driver focuses on driving, it will be difficult for him or her to do multiple tasks. Therefore, the digital cluster plays a very important role here. The digital cluster tells how fast the car is driving, how much fuel is left, and notifies the driver of problems on the digital screen. Do you know what the cluster is made up of? It basically consists of a speedometer, engine tachometer, fuel meter, and engine temperature gauge. In order to fulfill the legal display restrictions and to provide drivers the information they need in a convenient way, trip computer, warning lights, and driving information display are provided by the cluster. Here's a pop quiz. The standard cluster uses different colors to signal the driver for different purposes. Guess what those colors are? 1, 2, 3. The answer is red, yellow, and green. Did you get all the answers? Okay then, do you know what each color means? The red light represents danger. For example, if there are problems with the airbag or shortage in engine oil, or if you forget to fasten your seatbelts, then the red light reminds you to carry out a safety inspection immediately. And for yellow, it does not represent immediate danger, but it says that you need to check certain parts. For instance, the yellow light is on when the air pressure of the wheels is low, or the washer fluid is inadequate. Last but not least, the green light represents the current status. It shows the operational status of the vehicle, just like the turn signal light, tail lamp, and headlamps. So these are the standard color signals widely used in conventional clusters. The conventional clusters, aka analog clusters, uses needles to indicate speed, RPM, and fuel tank status. But recently, analog gauge is slowly phasing out. It is being replaced by the digital cluster, which only uses an LCD to display information. Even though there are several reasons behind this replacement, I think the most important reason should be the fact that the autonomous era is coming soon. Do you remember when we talked about ADAS? If you don't, please check out episode 1. As more cars adapt ADAS technology, digital cluster now has a role to provide more information to drivers, such as pedestrian warning or keeping a safe distance from other cars. It also acts as a functional safety component to inform the driver the status of the car if there's any technical issues. That's why the screen of the digital cluster is gradually getting bigger and bigger recently. Let me show you a couple of examples. This is MVIX, a cockpit concept developed by Movis. It uses 3D layered lightning tech mounted on the cluster to give the driver a more intuitive visual of the information. It also has the display screen for entertainment attached to the cluster, which can be shifted to the front passenger seat. In the near future, digital clusters can get seriously bigger like these. Look at this Envision S, which is a concept car that was introduced at CES 2020. It has a large transparent display screen at the front, which acts as a cluster. A similar concept was also introduced in Envision Pop like this. But ultimately, when fully autonomous cars are on the road, digital clusters can take different forms and shapes, like this one. This strange-looking mini tower is called Monolith Vertical Cockpit, which replaces the driver's existing cluster. So these are the glimpses of how future clusters will evolve into. Aren't these so cool? Well, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed today's episode too. I'll see you next time with more interesting topics, so please look forward to it. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit the subscribe and to leave comments, as well as to turn on the notification. Bye!